Pasaulio futbolo čempionato atrankos rungtynės. Lietuva, Slovakija. Birželio 10 dieną, tik per LRT.
The game plan was to be compact in the pressure and also try to eat the opponent because we knew that we should have more power than Faroe Islands during the whole match, and I think that worked. Hit them on counterattacks when we got the ball. And in certain times keep the ball flowing so that the Faroe Islands would run a lot without the ball. And I think pretty much everything worked, so that was very, very good. And then we hit the goal 3 times, so it was not bad.
Individually, ką išskirtų iš savo komandos žaidėjų?
Individually, which players would you pick out from your team?
Well, first of all, I need to say it's a team effort, but I think Elegius, he did very well. He's a very good player because every time he got the ball, you could just hear the crowd expecting something, and also you could see that Faroe Islands were nervous when he got the ball. And he, you know, a player like that can do something on his own is so important for the team. So because we were a little nervous in the beginning of the match, I think everyone could see that the guys were a little nervous, holding back, and pretty fast Aliga got a good chance, and he can kind of pull the team with him when he shows this level here. So very important player. But otherwise, I think it's a team effort. I think Aldous, who came in on right back in the second half, he did very well. Left back in first half, or the whole game, Dominikas did also, you know, a very good game to cause trouble for Faroe Islands and, you know, on the sides. So yeah, Edwin is sometimes he's working alone, as a striker. So it's a very tough job for him, and he does so well. To sometimes keep the ball and move the team, and he's always in the box creating not only chances for himself but also for the other guys. It was so nice to see him score, so you know he deserves it. So yeah, some of the players that I would mention.
Also Boris Ditkevičius has said that today. How would you rate his performance and how important is for him to, you know, came in?
Yeah. It's the first time for him, and I could see, you know, tactically, I could see he was a little bit, sometimes he didn't do what we wanted, but individually, I think he did what he was supposed to do. You could see his level on the ball, and I think he was aggressive. So, you know, that was the two things that I was looking for first, and of course I was hoping that he could go and finish off the match. So, yeah, I think it's a good performance for him.
Of course, it's a comfortable win, but how the team fulfilled your expectations in regards, you know, the training before the game, and how are you delighted with your team performance?
Yeah.
In terms of tactical.
Exactly. I think, as I told you, that the guys were nervous in the beginning. They were not playing as fast as I think we should have done. But you could still see the structure in the team. You could see what we wanted to do. We just lost the last details in what we wanted to do. We didn't have the level that we possess in the beginning, but I could still see the concept. And during the whole match, as I told them before the match, this is going to be 90 minutes. We should not expect to close this game after 15, 20, 30 minutes. Maybe we'll close the game at the end. If we just stick to the concept, and these players, you know, I have to praise them because they just suck it all up. You know, everything I say also during the match, they just deliver. It's fantastic, and it's so, you know, they deserve it so much, these guys. So, you know, if you were a club coach, One week before we beat, you know, Latvia, you could just see in that 1 week, as we talked about before, how the concept set was just put on the pitch by the players. Now 2 weeks in, we beat the Faroe Islands with the concept. You know, you can see the concept at 3-0 again here. So this is just crazy. You know, club coach after 2 weeks, Would he expect the team to deliver already? No. Well, so this just shows how these guys work. Fantastic.
And also, you made a substitution during halftime. You substituted Audrius Lauchisin for Korsakas. What was the idea behind that substitution? And did you intend to play more on the right side of the pitch?
Not tactical actually. It was because Lauchis had problems with his legs. We knew it was a little, it was a chance to bring him from the start. But I think he did very well in the training camp before the game. But he got heavy legs, and we didn't want to take any chances. So, and Aldous is a quality player, and he showed that in the second half when he came in. So. That's why we need two good players in each position. So there's no worries, but it was no tactical decision. It was nearly because Lauchis had heavy legs.
Yes, also, did you have any injury problems before the game? Did it change your plans for starting lineup?
Not before the game, before the camp. So we have Domantas Šimkus is injured. But not during this camp. We had no problems. So I have to also praise the staff. I've told them directly on the camp, but it's so professional what they do, and that's why the players are ready all the time, because I want to proceed and I want to be on the training pitch with these guys and learn and teach. But they're always monitoring and doing the right things, and we have a very good communication in the staff to treat the players the right way, so it's a pleasure.
And also, the final question, how it's important to start the qualification cycle with a win against Faroe Islands, was ahead of crucial games against strong teams.
Exactly. So it's, I cannot emphasize enough how important it is for these guys, because as you saw in the beginning, they were a little bit nervous, and that's a good symbol of how it is with these guys. I don't think they know their own strength yet. So now we won 3-0 against Latvia, 3-0 against Faroe Islands. So I think it must, soon they must know. Yeah. So we can go with the confidence that we need for the Denmark match. That's so important. And I also told the players before the match that you need this win to have the confidence, to bring in the next assignment you got in qualification. And then I need to say that the boost, the push that this crowd gave us was just fantastic. I didn't expect something like this. Maybe a little slow start, but during the match, these people, they just helped the team. They were the 12th player. It was just fantastic atmosphere here in this stadium here. So I must praise these guys, these kids, these housewives, whoever sat in the stands. It was just fantastic. We could feel it all the way down to the pitch. So.
Tikrai šiom rungtynėm ruošėmės atidžiai, nes žinojom, kad reikia startą Europos čempionato kvalifikaciją pradėti pergalę, vis tiek Farerai silpnesnė šalis. Ir tiesiog norėjom laimėti. Kitos išeities mes neturėjom, būtume pralošę, būtų didelė tragedija, aš manau, o pergalė didžiulį skirtume, 3-0 galim dar daugiau įmušti, tai patenkinti, žiūrim toliau.
Asmeniškai pačiam nepavyko pelnyti įvartį, pasitaupė kitom rungtynėm?
Biškiai esant įsiminęs, kad neįmušau, nes noriu kiekvienose rungtynėse mušti, padėti komandai, bet toks ir yra komandinis sportas, neįmuši tu, įmuši komandos draugai. Aišku, dar pasilikau kitom rungtynėm, svarbesniem taip pat.
Buvai kaip gyvas sidabras šiandieną, žaidėjai vienam ir kitam krašte, ne vieną kartą sulaukė plojimo audrų, jau tai, kad publika palaiko.
Jo, ir iš tikrųjų Telšiuose pirmą kartą žaidžiu ir didelis palaikymas, norėčiau padėkoti jiem, kad palaikė mus, ir jeigu tikiuosi žaisim vėl čia, kad ateitų tiek pat žmonių, gal ir daugiau ir taip pat palaikytų, ir žinoma, bandysim atsidėkoti jiem pergalę.
Dabar laukia rungtynės su stipriais varžovais, su Danais, su Lenkais, tai yra dar komandų. Ar kalbėjote jau su treneriu, ką trenerius sako, būtent apie sekančius rungtynės, ar dar, pavyzdžiui, ar nelėkite tas?
Ne, mes kaip susirinkam, ruošiamės tom rungtynėm. ruošiam treneriai, daro nastabų darbą, analizės, viską, tik ruošiamės tom rungtynėm. Ateis kitos rungtynės, mes ruošiamės kitom rungtynėm. Taip ir dirbamės.
Ir koks buvo trenerių planas, prašymas, ką akcentavo būtent rungtynėse prieš Farerų visų rungtynę?
Pradžioj sakėm, gal nespausim jų, nes galim palikti didelės erdvės ir gali jie to pasinaudoti. Bandėm polietą, pažingsnio, eiti į priekį. Ir aišku, kontroliuoti žaidimą, nes esam stipresnė už Farerus ir turėjom visišką kamalio kontrolį. Ir išnaudas žinoma progas, nes jeigu neišnaudasi progų, kaip tu laimėsi.
Regiau, kaip sekasi dirbti su naujoju treneriu ir kaip apibūdintum jo žaidimo filosofiją, ko jis iš jūsų reikalavo?
Nu, tikrai, Danų treneriai tikrai labai įdomus, visai kitoks žaidimo stilius, kontroliuoti kamuolį, daug taktikų, apsikeitimų. Ir manau, tas labai gerai, nes reikia žaisti futbolą šiais laikais, nes jeigu tu spardysi į priekį, tu nieko nelaimėsi. Kad ir dėsi silpna šalis už Lenkus ar kitus, tu turi žais. Jeigu presinguosi jas pirs kamuolį, tai tas pats kaip ir mes. Tai treneriai bando tą įskiepyti ir taip ir darom, kaip nieko nepakeisi.